Hi, I'm Tony Velasquez, and welcome to Future Perfect Tech Shorts. It's been a rather busy month in the world of consumer electronics, and June isn't even over yet. Microsoft gave a preview of a potentially game-changing update to its Xbox ecosystem. Apple brought out the Retina display to the MacBook and shows off its upcoming operating system upgrades. And Windows 8 and Windows RT finally show up in several intriguing upcoming products, including Microsoft's latest stab at the tablet market.
Computex 2012 showcased some amazing new Windows devices, with Taiwanese firm ASUS again leading the pack and Acer close on its heels. Building on the success of its Android tablet notebook hybrids, ASUS introduced several new Transformer books running the upcoming flavors of Windows. There's a Transformer book with Windows RT for those who want Tegra 3, and an Intel-based Windows 8 for those who want to keep their desktop environment with their tablet. But by far the most intriguing beast to be showcased in Computex was the Tai Chi, a dual-screen Windows 8 device that does not require you to detach the keyboard for it to transform into a tablet. With still 4 months to go before Windows 8 and the ARM-based Windows RT launch, things are already looking good for Steve Ballmer and company. Gamers did not have quite the field day they were expecting in this year's Electronic Entertainment Expo, or E3. Only Nintendo bothered to demo a next-generation gaming console at the event. Microsoft, however, did show off an update to its Xbox system that signals that Redmond is aiming to dominate the living room. Microsoft demoed Smart Glass, an app for mobile devices that lets you interact with video content and games on the Xbox 360. Start watching a movie on your mobile device and you can pick up where you left off on your TV when you get home. Smart Glass also uses your tablet or smartphone as a supplemental screen, offering up contextual information for movies and games. The best part? The app will be available on Windows, Android, and even iOS devices. The days of smearing your oily fingers on touchscreens may also finally be over. Nico just demoed analog controllers for Android and iOS devices that promise to take tablet gaming closer to the console experience and give the PS Vita a run for its money. Speaking of iOS, Apple has just unveiled the latest version of its venerable mobile operating system. iOS 6 boasts of better Facebook integration and an updated Siri, which will be making her debut on the new iPads. Macs are also about to get upgraded to OS X Mountain Lion, which aims to bring Apple's desktop and mobile environments even closer. Apple is also bringing its Retina display technology to its laptops, with a new MacBook Pro boasting a screen of 2880 by 1800 pixels. Macs are also getting faster guts, courtesy of Intel's latest Ivy Bridge goodies. The biggest surprise, however, came from Microsoft yet again. Looks like the software behemoth is aiming to become a hardware giant as well, as it introduced its own Windows 8 and Windows RT powered tablets. The tablets, named Surface, have taken a page from the success of the ASUS Transformer pads, as well as Apple's own smart cover. Surface tablets come with an even smarter cover that doubles as a keyboard and trackpad. Geeks who have been lusting for a tablet that can do real work will also salivate to know that there will be a Surface tablet that has Ivy Bridge guts and which can run demanding desktop apps like Adobe's Creative Suite. The Redmond-based empire, however, was noticeably mum on exactly when these goodies are going to ship. And we're not done yet. Google is about to hold its own I/O event next week, where rumors say it will unveil its own tablet. But with so many devastating shots already fired from the camps of Apple and Microsoft, Google definitely will need to come up with something thermonuclear to stay in the game.
And you can do that with any device.
All those goodies. Coming up, we'll take a closer look at the premier consumer electronics event in Asia and put a smartphone that turns into a tablet to the test. Keep it here on Future Perfect Tech Shorts. We'll be right back.
Ang thrust kasi ng karamihang tech show ngayon are mainly addressed to consumers. Di ba? Your information consumer consume this application. Your technology consumer consume. No, what I'd like, the tech show that I'd like to see is more showing or like leading audience towards becoming technology producers. Like what we have done here. We have produced a lot of technology here in this school. We have produced a lot of applications. And these are the things that allowed us to move forward in a very large scale, meaning to do it school-wide because of the technology that we produce. So if Tony can only just like encourage more, be more creative in creating or presenting a tech show that will encourage Filipinos or his audience to become technology producers instead of technology consumers.
We really need this kind of shows, especially from our side, for people to have interest in science and technology. At malaki naman talaga role ng science and technology for the future. So definitely we need shows like this. People are now recognizing or acknowledging the role of science and technology. Now, shows like Future Perfect, always you should learn from the past and plan for your future. A key element talaga ng not only scientists, of all students, yung ano dapat eh, to be able to imagine. Kasi if you look at the future, that is imagination. That is dreaming. What is the future? That is visioning. And that is very, very important. Ang future, because of ICT, will be very, very different. Kaya lalo nagiging importante yung Future Perfect, because dapat we should be able to imagine what we want in the future using ICT and other technology.
Well, Secretary Montejo and Engineer Lozada, as they said in the impeachment trial, noted. Microsoft made a big splash earlier this week as it unveiled its own drool-worthy next-generation tablet hybrids, but Windows 8 actually made its consumer electronics debut earlier this month at the Computex 2012 in Taiwan. Now, Abe Olandres of TechBlog Yugatech.com was among the Filipino journalists who attended the event. And he joins us now on Future Perfect Tech Shorts to share his experiences at the expo, as well as introduce us to a gadget that truly defines a convergence device. Abe, fresh from his travels, so where have you been gallivanting around, Abe, without me?
Hi, Tony. Glad to be back here.
You actually went to Taiwan, right?
Yeah, we spent Computex. Like a couple of days there, roaming the halls of Computex, yeah. And, you know, oogling at all the gadgets. Really big halls. Yeah. It doesn't fit actually just one big complex, but several complexes across Taipei. So it's really, really took us a lot of it.
But one theme, which actually runs across, I guess, all of the exhibits, is how the electronics manufacturers want to integrate Windows 8 into their touchscreen systems.
Yeah, that's right. Actually, this I think that would be the major theme of the Computex this year. A lot of manufacturers are introducing Windows 8 in a hybrid format, wherein you have the tablet form factor, and then you plug it into the keyboard, and you got productivity. It's an ultrabook or a netbook.
And obviously, Microsoft with Surface trying to basically create a hybrid, but with a different format, using a cover.
Yeah, it's interesting that Microsoft is actually entering and somewhat competing against its partners, the OEMs here. But exactly. I guess their main goal there is to showcase what Windows 8 can become. Mm-hmm. And hopefully the manufacturers would follow suit.
I remember you were here many, many months ago on Future Perfect. And we actually had, I think, what was it? Like a beta version of Windows, Windows 8, right?
Yeah, we tried out Windows 8.
Yeah, on the laptop, they installed it. Actually, a netbook.
Yeah, on a netbook. It's actually, it also works on netbook.
It works, right? So How much more different is the execution of Windows 8 on the devices that you've seen in Computex?
Actually, it's pretty interesting because Microsoft intends to combine the power portability of a tablet, which it had tried many years ago but failed, and then including productivity suites like Microsoft Office, Adobe, and all the stuff that we normally use on a laptop. So this time, I think Microsoft hit it on
they
the
got
head.
It right.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, do we have any Windows 8 devices?
Actually, since it's not officially out, I've tried it on my Ultrabook. I have it at home. I installed the latest version. It's really good. But I think the things that we're really excited at that I actually bought from Computex is
you did. Uh-huh.
They call it the 3-in-1. A lot of my readers call it the 3-in-1.
The 3-in-1. Uh-huh. Okay, it's not coffee. it's actually a tablet. With a keyboard dock, and what is the third element that makes it the 3-in-1?
Actually, the one that powers it is actually a smartphone.
It's a phone, right. So the 3-in-1 is a touchscreen tablet, a keyboard dock, and
a smartphone,
which is an Android smartphone. Yeah. Mm.
So the idea is actually very interesting because it's the only one that we've seen being implemented actually now. So you see, Asus has been doing that, the transformer type. So this is the second generation. It's a tablet with a keyboard dock, which you can plug it in. You get like two batteries in here, so you can get as much as 18 hours of battery life.
Running ice cream sandwich.
But they move a step further and thought of actually putting a smartphone inside a tablet to power the tablet. So they got something like this.
Looks similar. Of course,
it's a little thicker.
It's thicker. Let's put a side by side comparison here. There you go. So I'm just going to rotate the table. Much thicker, obviously, because there's a slot at the back of the tablet where you put in the smartphone. So can you open that?
There's a slider here. You can just pull that out, and you will see.
And there is a phone inside. How do you unlock?
So it's plugged via the HDMI and the USB port. So just push a little bit,
And it's unlocked.
Unlocked.
Okay. There you go. You slide it out. The phone itself isn't any much thicker than what you would expect, right?
The phone is under 10 millimeters thin, and it's actually the brain of the tablet itself. So without the phone, tablet is actually dead.
It's dead.
Basically a zombie.
So it doesn't have its own OS
Own OS, nothing. It's basically the screen and another set of batteries inside here.
Okay.
So it's cheaper to produce because you rely mainly on the smartphone as your center. And everything that you have in here would actually be reflected on the tablet when you put it in.
Okay, so show us what's on the phone the phone right now.
So if you see the phone, there is like an Android ICS.
Typical ICS,
sandwich.
Home screen.
It's a 4.3-inch smartphone powered by Android ICS. Super AMOLED screen, really good.
Is that a quad-core phone already?
Yeah, it's a dual. It's a dual-core Crate. Mm-hmm. This is the fastest from Qualcomm.
All right.
And then if you
put it inside the dock.
So there are two ports here. Mm-hmm. One is for the USB and one is for the micro HDMI.
Okay. So both connect simultaneously.
Yep.
All right. So once you plug that in, and let's look at how the screen looks like now.
So the screen is transformed into the tablet UI. Everything is as if you're just using a 10-inch tablet.
So it doesn't obviously just mirror what's on the smartphone, but converts itself into
so the UI
the tablet
looks like how you would see it if you're using an Android tablet. And of course the tablet itself also has its own battery, and then if you dock it on the keyboard, the keyboard also has a battery.
So in essence, because you put a phone inside the shell, which is the tablet, that you're getting 3G connectivity right away. Which means you can also not just do data, but you can also do voice and text messages.
Yep, you can. So you have direct internet via the HSPA Plus here. And then you have voice, and you also have SMS. So there are applications here you can do to send SMS.
So you can send SMS using the keyboard dock, no?
Yep. And you can also do
voice
phone.
Okay. Now, How do you make a call? Do you talk to the tablet's speaker or microphone?
Normally, you would think that you would pull out the phone and then make a call. But yeah. It also comes with this really nice, nifty stylus. So it acts like your finger, so you don't have to smudge your screen.
Right.
But it's also a Bluetooth headset. So there's a battery in here, and then Bluetooth, which is paired on the phone.
Yeah.
So when you make a call, just use it like so.
Really?
Yeah.
So that's actually the handset when you think about it.
It's basically the handset. You don't have to pull it out.
And what is the audio quality on that?
It's more like CD quality because it connects via Bluetooth. So actually the voice quality is very very crisp, as if you're actually using the phone itself.
Uh-huh.
And it's no different from using a Bluetooth headset, the one that you're the wireless.
Yeah. And we brought another.
I also bought mine. So
that's your own.
It comes with. I didn't buy the keyboard, so I just borrowed this one. So it's the same thing. So you can make the same calls. Between the two tablets, maybe.
And just to be clear, no, it has to be that specific phone that goes with it. It can't be any phone, diba?
Actually, I think since this is Bluetooth, it can pair.
No, I mean the dock.
The dock,
It has to be that specific.
It has to
phone.
Be this this phone and this dock because Asus manufactured it like this. So it only I'm not sure if the first generation transformer pad, the first generation, can actually also fit with this.
With
one.
The dock.
That's just the keyboard.
Now. Can you try demonstrating a phone call from one pad phone to the other? So who should we call?
Who should we call?
Should we call Makati Medical Center now? No, let's not try that again. Okay. We already tried that earlier.
Whose number are we calling?
Okay. Whose number?
Any volunteers?
We can call the newsroom.
Yeah,
we can call the newsroom. So, 924-4101.
924-4101.
Okay. So you can I don't have to press anything?
Yeah.
I just speak straight into it, okay?
Thank you for calling ABS.
Oh, it's on speaker.
So you press 1.
If you have a touchtone phone and know the local
ring up the
number
dialer.
You want
1.
To reach, press, please enter your 5323 now. Or
so I have to. Do you have to kill the speaker?
You can use the. You can press the button there.
This one. Uh-huh. But I can talk directly, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hello. Yes, sir.
Can you hear me?
Can put like it.
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. This is Tony Velasquez. You are now live on ANC Future Perfect. Actually, because we are testing a new device, and you happen to be my guinea pig.
Okay.
Yes, that's okay. Yeah, we're actually calling you from an Asus pad phone, using a Bluetooth stylus device. So, how clear am I? Am I clear to you?
Yes, sir. Very clear.
Fantastic. All right. So we just demonstrated how well we can make phone calls from a tablet that is docked to a keyboard using a stylus Bluetooth handset. Isn't that cool?
Yes, I can see you.
You can see me. Unfortunately, I can't see you. But your voice, is now immortalized in tech history. And why don't you say hello to the viewers?
Hello to the viewers of ANC.
Yeah, introduce yourself.
This is Rafi from the news desk.
Fantastic. You know, Rafi, you could have a good career as a DJ. Great voice. Thank you very much.
All right.
So you cut that. Hey, that's pretty good, huh? Uh-huh. I mean, I would actually imagine just how convenient it is that you're working on your laptop and you remember, I have to make a phone call, and you don't have to bring out your phone, you just make the call.
Actually,
but obviously, you have to mute that because you don't want everybody to listen to what you're talking
about.
And
a lot of people now, they have a tablet, they have a phone, they have a laptop in their bag. So maybe Asus is thinking that, you know, a convergent device such as the Asus Pad phone can replace probably all three of your devices.
Fantastic. Uh-huh. Now, what is this fiery looking device?
So last year when they launched a transformer pad, they call it transformer, they introduced a more affordable version. So this is somewhere around 24,995.
Okay. So affordable, like, is relative, eh?
It's relative. Because it used to be like 33,000 when they first launched it.
Why is it much cheaper than the Transformer?
So some of the materials they used here, instead of aluminum, magnesium alloy, they use some
plastic.
Sort of polycarbonate material. So it's basically plastic.
But
here.
The innards?
Yeah. But the innards is basically the same as the first Transformer. So it's powered by Tegra 3 quad core processor. Yeah. You have internal storage here, 32 gig, and then a 10.1-inch screen. Okay. This one is actually ran out of battery, but the other.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. More premium tablet would be
the Transformer Prime HD.
The HD. So this is a 1080p screen.
Yeah.
So when you're watching maybe movies and
kitang-kita ang bawat hibla. Ang bawat skin pore. Uh-huh. So anyway, we're running out of time, Abe. I'm sorry to actually bring this to you, but we're a much shorter Future Perfect show now. But just in essence, what you've seen from Computex, the Windows 8 adoption by the tech companies, of course, what Microsoft is doing now. What do you think is going to happen? Is Windows 8 going to take off, maybe like Android did?
Actually, I think Microsoft has been very, very wary about the popularity of the iPad, and then here you've got Android all over, where all OEMs are actually producing their Android tablets. And Microsoft, being, you know, been in the industry for so long, I think it's high time that they have something that is really, really usable on a portable, on a tablet, basically.
On a tablet.
And the one, the Microsoft Surface, is something really, really promising. I think that would ignite enthusiasm among Windows users again from switching
from
away.
People who've migrated to Mac
away
OS.
Away to Mac or
even to Android. All right, well, we don't have any actual device yet, but as you did say, you've tried installing
Hopefully
it on the
netbook. Hopefully by October we'll see something when Windows 8 is officially released.
Right, and see just how productive people can be using that new device. Well, Abe, always a pleasure to have you on the show.
Yeah, glad to be here.
Hopefully get to hang on to your coattails and travel along with you again when you hop to another tech destination.
Yeah, next time.
Thanks, Doc. Yeah. All right, Em, thank you for joining us. I'm Tony Velasquez. Join me again next week when we again examine the present and look ahead to the future perfect of Philippine tech.